Welcome to part 2 of the Variant Manager video series. In part 1, we saw the Viper system model, which has an option to run under multiple modes. We used Variant Manager to visualize model hierarchy, auto-generate configurations, and add custom configurations, control variables, and constraints. Finally, we stored our configurations and constraints in Simulink Variant Configuration Data object. In this video, we will see how we can analyze our configurations and reduce our model using Variant Manager. When you have multiple configurations in a single model, you may need to compare them to identify errors and inconsistencies in the model, to view behavior of any element in the model, or to perform trait studies across configurations. This brings us to the next step, which is analyzing our model to compare and contrast multiple configurations. Now you can select the Variant Analyzer option and then select the configuration you want for the analysis. Now click on Analyze Model. This generates Variant Analysis, which shows the selected configurations, model hierarchy, and if a block is active or inactive in the selected configurations. This is a heat map where highlighted cell means the block is inactive in the respective configuration, and check mark means that the block is active. The activeness column shows if the block is active, inactive, or partially active in the set of selected configurations. And the annotations mentioned in the table represents the condition which are shown at the bottom. Now let's look at the analysis more closely. In this example, the analysis shows that the fog sensor is never activated for any of these configurations. This shows that we have untested or dead region in our model. No configuration is covering this sensor. So we may choose to add another configuration which activates the fog sensor, or if we don't want to consider using the sensor, then we may choose to remove the fog sensor input from our model. You can get more such insights using the analysis. Now, once you have done your analysis, you may consider focusing your efforts on specific set of configurations or selectively share your model with a limited number of configurations. In such cases, you can create separate model with the required configurations. Which brings us to the last part, reduce. The Viper model consists of multiple blocks encompassing smart and manual speed modes. Now, let us reduce this model. Go to Variant Manager and then click on Variant Reducer. Now, select any one reduction mode. Here, we will use the Variant Configuration mode. Now, let us say we decide not to opt for smart sensor to minimize our expenses, and we want to share this model with the supplier. Then we can leverage our analysis to identify configurations that do not rely on smart sensors or smart input blocks. And by doing so, we can choose and share only those configurations that are relevant and beneficial to the supplier. Then select the output folder location, which will encompass the reduced model and all related artifacts. Also, you can select the Generate Detailed Summary option if you want a detailed report. After selection, click on Reduce Model. This creates and automatically opens a separate Simulink model. You will notice that the reduced model has captured only the necessary blocks which were required in our selected configurations. And by examining the Variant Manager of this reduced model, you will find only the selected configurations. This means we have successfully reduced our model. To get more information on Variant Manager, you can use the Getting Started tab or use the Help icon at the top. Now you can easily manage, analyze, and reduce your model with Variant Manager. Thank you for watching this video. You may refer more such videos on our YouTube channel and MathWorks website.